synchron generator. The last session we have seen that the synchronous generator is an electrical machine which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. To produce the electrical energy, we have seen that there are three things are necessary. One is the field, the other one is the conductor, the third one is the relative motion between the conductor and the field. In the last session, we have seen that the stator part of the synchronous machine, which is the armature. Now, today's session, we will discuss the rotor, that is the field system. We have seen that there are two parts mainly. One is the stator, in which we have got a armature conductors or armature winding. It is wound for three different windings for R and Y and B because it is a three-phase generator. And we have got the second part, that is the rotor, which is a rotating part. In the case of the alternator, the rotor is the magnetic field system. To create the magnetic flux, then what we are using is, in this case, is the rotor. It is excited by DC supply. Basically, the rotor consists of electromagnets and it has got a field winding so that it has to create the magnetic flux. Then there is a supply, that is, external supply is given to the field winding so that it is creating the magnetic flux. Then we will see the details of this rotor. We have seen where to brush up the what all things are there in the generator. Basic parts of the synchronous generators are rotor, that is a field system. Then there is a stator, that is a three-phase winding in which there is a generated voltage, that is also called as the armature. Then we have seen the stationary part of the machine, which is the armature. It is consist of the number of the conductors. They are connected in three different windings, R and Y and B. Then the stationary part of the machine, that is a stator, is also made up of laminations so that they have to reduce the eddy current and hysteresis slot. And there is an inner periphery of the stator. We have got a slots. In that slots, we are keeping the armature conductors. That you have seen in the last class. This is the stator structure. Okay, you have got the inner periphery of the stator. We have got slots. In these slots, the conductors are placed. Then this is one for three windings. Okay, once again, the stator part is made up of laminations. It is looks like a solid body, but however, it is made up of lamination to reduce the hysteresis and eddy current loss. Then, in today's session, we will see in detail the rotor part of an alternator or a synchronous generator. In the rotor, it is our name itself suggests that it is a rotating part, is called the magnetic field. In the case of the alternator, rotor is nothing but it is consist of magnetic field structure carrying the DC excited winding so that it has to create the magnetic flux. The rotor may be constructed with two different types of poles, that is, one is called as the salient pole type, or it may be non-salient or cylindrical type. That is, the rotor construction, in the case of the alternator, there are two types. One is called as salient pole, that is, the poles are projected, that is called as a salient pole, and a non-salient pole, or it is looks like a cylindrical, the whole structure is looks like a cylindrical, therefore it is also called as non-salient. Means, the based on the rotor construction, the synchronous generators are classified into salient pole generator. If the poles are projected, it is called as salient pole generator. If the rotor is non-salient or cylindrical, it is called as non-salient or cylindrical rotor type of synchronous machine. In any of the alternator, either you have got a salient pole or you have got a non-salient. That is, the based on the rotor construction, it is called as a salient pole synchronous machine if the rotor is the salient pole or the poles are projected. That machine is called as salient full synchronous machine. If the rotor is non-salient or cylindrical, then it is called as cylindrical or round rotor synchronous machine. Then what is the features of the salient pole type of the rotor and non-salient pole type of the rotor, that we'll see now. In the salient pole type, the salient means, the term salient means it is a projecting, means the poles are projected. I'll show you the diagram, how it looks like. The term salient means it is a projecting. The salient pole type is generally used for low speed operation. That is the first point regarding the salient pole type is, it is the projecting type of poles are there in the salient pole. Because the salient poles are projecting, the poles are projecting, then it is attached to the rotor. Then if it is rotated with very high speed, there is a centrifugal force are exerted on these poles. Therefore, there should not be any uneven incident to take place. Therefore, these salient pole type of alternators are designed for very low speed operation. Usually, the speed is around 100 to 400 RPM. These are driven by the hydraulic turbines or diesel engines. Basically, these poles are projected one, and these machines are, this type of machines, that is a salient pole type of alternator rotor, they are used for the low speed machine. Then having a large diameter and relatively small axle length. That is, the diameter of the rotor is more because the poles are projecting. If the poles are projecting, means ultimately the diameter of the rotor is more. However, the axial length is the small in this type of machine. The poles are made up, once again, laminated steel. Also, these poles are also made up of laminations. It is looks like a solid body, but all these made up of laminations and stamped together to minimize the hysteresis and eddy current loss. And these poles are attached to the rotating body with the help of a joint. They are joining to the rotating body here. In the case of the salient pole type, the air gap, that is a gap between the stator and the rotor, is not uniform throughout. Because wherever there is a projecting, in that case, the air gap, that is a gap between the stator and the rotor, is small. Whereas the interpolar axis, in that case, the air gap is large. Therefore, what we are getting is a non-uniform air gap in the case of the salient pole type of generator. And the pole is occupying 2/3 of the pole pitch. These are the salient features of the salient pole type of a generator. That is, it is a projected poles. These are designed for low speed. The speed is around 100 to 400 RPM. It is driven by the hydraulic turbines or a diesel engines. In the case of this type of machine, the diameter is the large, whereas the axle length is less. And once again, the poles are made up of laminations. These are connected to the rotating body with the help of a joint. And the air gap in the case of the salient pole type of alternator is non-uniform. Then the pole shows are occupying 2/3 of the pole pitch. These are the salient features of salient pole alternator. You can see here, that is, it is a projecting one. The projected portion, it is connected to here. If you are driven with a very high speed, then there is a detachment of the pole from the rotating body. That is why these are designed for the low speed. Whereas the diameter of this is more in the case of the salient pole, whereas the axial length, that is the axial length, is very small. Then the important point is that the air gap is not uniform. I told you, this is your stator, this is your rotor. You can see here, air gap is small here. However, the interpolar, here the air gap is large. Therefore, the air gap is not throughout the uniform, because here it is more, here it is less, here it is less, here it is more. Like that, we are getting non-uniform of the air gap in the case of the salient pole type of alternator. You can see here, this is a exact the pole. This is a field winding. It is a field winding. It is act as a pole here. This is a projecting body. This is a projecting body. I'll show you another the photograph. You can see here. This is a field winding. It is a projected portion of the pole. Still further clarity, you can see here. These are the projected poles. Here we have got the field windings. These are the field winding. Here we are giving a DC supply through a slip rings here. Here these are the slip rings, positive and negative. Through this it is excited here. All these are connected in series so that it is a projected, it is act as a the pole. You can see here, if you are presuming that there is a stator here, here the air gap is small, but in the interpolar axis the air gap is large. Therefore it is a non-uniform of the air gap you are getting in the salient pole type of alternator. You can see here, this C, it is a projected one, projected alternator. It is hinged to the rotating body. Okay, this is what you are calling as the salient pole type of the alternator. In the examination, if you ask to draw the construction of the alternator with a salient pole, then you have to show this particular diagram. You can see here, it is given, these are the stator. In the inner periphery of the stator, we have got a slots. In that case, we are keeping the armature conductors here. See here, it is a projected pole. It is a salient pole. It is a projected. See here, the gap here is small. The gap here is the large. It is a non-uniform air gap. And the diameter is more here because there is a projected poles here. See here, these are the field winding to create the magnetic flux. Then these are the two brushes and there is a slip ring here. These are connected to the DC supply. Okay, this is a rotating part. This salient pole. Salient pole means it is a projected one. Okay. In the next, we will start with the non-salient pole type of alternator. It is also called as the cylindrical type. That is, cylindrical rotor machines are also known as non-salient pole type of machine. It is called as non-salient, or it is a cylindrical type of machine. The construction of the rotor is such that it forms a smooth cylinder. It is looks like a smooth cylinder. Therefore, it is called as a cylindrical the rotor. It has no physical poles as in the salient pole construction. In the rotating body itself, the part of the portion is made for keeping the field winding, and part of the rotating body is act as a pole. These rotors are made up of, once again, good magnetic material with laminations. In about 2/3 of the rotor periphery, slots are cut at a regular interval and parallel to the shaft. That is, most of the 2/3 portion of the rotor body is consist of slots in which we are keeping the field winding. That I'll show with the help of the diagram. The DC field windings are connected in these slots. The unslotted portion, there is a total cylindrical body. In that, 2/3 portion of the body is cut with the slots. In that, we are keeping the field winding, and the rest of the rotating body is act as the poles. These machines have a small diameter because there is no projecting portion here. Therefore, the diameter are small here, and it has got a more axial length. That is, lengthwise it is more, the diameter is the less. Such construction limits the centrifugal force. Because it is smooth cylindrical type, Therefore, these machines are designed for high-speed alternator. That is, thus the cylindrical rotors are useful for high-speed machines. When the speed is we're getting high, in that case we are going for cylindrical type of the alternator. Then in the case of the cylindrical type of the rotor, the air gap is uniform. You can see the see this is a the stampings. Once again, it is also made up of a laminations. See, this is a whole the rotating body. The majority of the portion you are getting as slots here on the rotating body itself, in which you are keeping the field winding. We are keeping the field winding, and unslots portion of the rotating body is act as the poles. It is shown here the two pole. Here it is shown four pole machine. See here, these are slot in which we are keeping the field winding. You can see it is. See here, in all this it is filled with the field winding. Here, 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 and this portion is act as the pole. And if you are showing, if I ask you to draw the non-salient or cylindrical type of the alternator, then you have to show this figure and you have to explain the stator is common for salient and non-salient. For non-salient type of machine, you have to draw this one. You can see here the majority portion you have got in the outer periphery of the rotor, you have got slots in which you are keeping the field winding. Here it is a field winding, and this portion is act as a pole. It is act as a pole. This is once again it is a stator. Then overall, if you are looking into the alternator, the basically the alternator is consist of a stator part of the machine in which you are keeping the armature winding. It is wound for three phase because it is a three phase alternator, and there is a rotating body which is the field system which is creating the magnetic flux. Then these magnetic fields created by the magnets is electromagnets. To excite this magnets, what we need is a DC supply that we are getting from the slip rings here. Slip rings. It is overall construction of the alternator what we are seeing here. You look into the overall assembled diagram here. We have got the stator here. It is wound for a three-phase alternator. Three different windings are Y and B, and similar windings with phase displacement of 120 degree. This is a rotating part. This is how we have to write about the construction of the alternator. Usually, the question asked on this particular the construction part is that what are the different types of the alternators? That is one we have to call based on their rotor construction. Either it may be a non-salient or the salient pole type, and the stator is the same. The stator in which we are keeping the armature conductors in which there is a induced voltage, and the rotating for system is the field system which is creating the magnetic flux. And there are two types of the alternator based on the rotor construction. One is the salient pole, the another one is the non-salient. In the next session, we'll discuss the principle of operation of the alternator.